Peace be with you, men of God. I'm glad to meet you today too on our music lessons. I would like us to consider key signature. As I said previously, it's getting technical, so I would like you to follow keenly. I will do that in conjunction with scales. All right, a scale is just a succession of notes. But we have a particular scale known as a diatonic scale. A diatonic scale is a succession of notes without any accidental. So we have it as some of us can go do re mi fa sol la ti do. We will talk about these things later, but just to introduce it. Okay, so I would like us to use a scale of 8 notes or a diatonic scale of 8 notes starting on a C. In fact, I want us to know or study how we came by our key signatures. Now, what's a key signature? A key signature is the assemble or the assembly of accidentals at the beginning of every staff to alert or to inform the performer as to which notes are raised or lowered in the song. Alright, so I'll use the concept of scales and tetrachords. I'll tell you what a tetrachord is. Others decide to use what we call the cycle of fifths. I will decide to go by the use of tetrachords. A tetrachord is just a scale of 4 notes. A succession of 4 notes. So if I have 8 here, I will have 1, 2, 3, 4 as my tetrachord. I have another one from here, 1, 2, 3, 4 as another tetrachord. So in a diatonic scale, we have 2 tetrachords. What are they? The lower tetrachord and the upper tetrachord. Now, there's a characteristic of a diatonic scale. There should be a semitone. Now you know a semitone. A semitone is just a half step between two given pitches. Okay, so there should be a semitone at the third and fourth note of a scale and also at the seventh and eighth. It means that this distance, the distance between the third and fourth notes in a diatonic scale and the seventh and eighth, is naturally a semitone or are naturally semitones. We don't have to create or do anything to them before we obtain a semitone. Now, if we are supposed to use the letters, this is C, that is D, that is E, this is F, this is G, that is A, that is B, and this is C. It means that naturally, between E and F, and B and C, on the keyboard, between E, between E and F, and then B and C, you see that there is no black key between these two white keys, but they are considered semitones, and that's why they are natural semitones. All right, now, if we want to get the next key, in fact, this is key C. Why? Because it's starting on the C. The scale is starting on the C. All right. So to get the next key, we cannot just start from the next one, say D. No, because we want to build the key signature or the key signatures in order. So to get the first key signature, we will start from the upper tetrachord. The upper tetrachord starts on G. So let me bring the whole thing down here and see. We'll start on G, A, B, C, D, E, F, and end on another G, which is this piece. All right, so we go back to the principle. To have a diatonic scale, we need a semitone occurring at the third and fourth, and the seventh and eighth. Now let's see if you really have semitones occurring here. Now between B and C, you know that it is part of the natural semitones. So we leave it. It is satisfying that. Let's consider F and G. Let's look on the keyboard. Between F and G, it's not part of the natural semitones. Yet we need to make it a semitone. What do we do? We cannot change this or alter the last note because it has to satisfy where we started from. A diatonic scale says that where you start from a G, you should end on a G. If you start on a C, you should end on a C. So we can't alter this. We can only change this one. Okay, so by raising it, you use the sharp accidental. It means we have moved this one a semitone higher. It means it is on F, and that F now has been raised a semitone higher to F sharp. It means in a scale of G or in key G, we have only one sharp. So whenever you are playing a song in key G and you reach a note on F, you are not supposed to play that F unless you are required by a natural sign to play that white key. Otherwise, we observe that F as an F sharp. So we have only one sharp in key G. So if we want to create a key signature for this, we will just place accidental here at the beginning of the staff, so it tells whoever that's going to play or sing or perform anything in this that you are going to work in key G. It means that your tonic, that one reminds me of the names of the scale. Okay, so the first one is called tonic, the second is called super tonic. The third is called median. In fact, you don't need this one. I just want you to know the technical name, so when perchance I make use of them, you understand. So we have the tonic, supertonic, median. This is subdominant. And this is dominant. And that is submedian. And that is leading note, and that is the octave. You don't really need this one for now, but having mentioned tonic, I'll have to introduce this one to you. So whenever the tonic is starting on any of the lines, we name that scale or key by that particular line or scale. And that since this one is starting on a C, we call this scale the scale C or key C. This time our key is starting on G, so we name that by the line which is key G. And we know that in key G, to satisfy the scale which we'll be using to create our melodies and harmonies, we need to raise the F sharp or the F, so we have F sharp. Doing that, you need to just tell the performer that you are working in key G, knowing that your tonic will be here. The tonic is as well the tonal center. It means that's where your do, some of you will call your do, is where you are going to organize your melody around. Okay, now let's create the next key by building the tetrachords in the key G. So in key G, our lower tetrachord becomes this, and our upper tetrachord becomes that. So we build on the upper tetrachord. Let's clean some of these so we can bring this one down. In the upper tetrachord of G, it starts on a D. But we cannot start on this line because we may end up having a lot of ledger lines here which will not look nice. So I'll therefore clean this one too and come down to the next D, which is the space immediately below the first line. Alright, so we build our 8 notes starting on the upper tetrachord of G. where it started on D, we have just brought that one down. And remember, the F in that upper tetrachord was raised, so we maintain it here. All right, so we continue the scale and finish it. We started on D, we have to end on D. Now, to satisfy the scale of D, we need to go back to the principle. We need semitones occurring between the third and fourth, and the seventh and eighth. Now, this is satisfied already. Let's see if this one too will be okay. Between C and D, is it part of the natural semitones? C and D, no, it's not part of the natural semitones. Between C and D is a tone. So we need to close the gap by raising the last but one note, using a sharp. By so doing, we have now two sharps in the scale of D. So in key D, we have F, as is there, and then the C sharp. I'll bring it a bit forward or a bit ahead of the first one. For the sake of time, I will end here. Now it means that in key D, our tonal center is on this or that one, because this is D, that is D. It means that we are going to work around it. Our Do is D. In key G, our Do is G. But if we don't want to use Do, we call that one the tonal center. I will give you an exercise on the page for you to create the next key signature building on the scale of D. Thank you. Stay safe. Bye-bye.